Yo, folks, Tail the Tape brought to you by VeChain, the official Layer 1 blockchain of UFC. Marvin Vettori, the minus 250 betting favorite, is 29. Roman Dolidze got a late start in MMA. He's 34. Dolidze 2 inches taller. That matches his advantage in reach. All right, now for the introductions. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are... And now, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. I'm the martial artist holding a professional record. 12 wins, 1 loss. He stands 6'2" tall, weighing in at 186 pounds. Fighting out of Batumi, Georgia, presenting the number 9 ranked UFC middleweight contender in the world, Roman Dolidze! Now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record, 18 wins, 6 losses, 1 draw, he stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 185 and 1 half pounds, fighting out of Mezzo Corona, Italy, presenting the number 4 ranked UFC middleweight contender in the world, Marvin, the Italian Dream, Vettori! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Mark Goddard.
One of the best in the business, Mark Goddard, will also handle the co-headliner tonight. Carly Baker with us in London, as is standard. New look corner for Marvin Vettori features Dewey Cooper, Jason Manley, Emmanuel Lochner as well. This fight clock is brought to you by Timex, official timekeeper of UFC, the only watch tough enough for UFC.
You know, one of the things that really impresses me about Marvin is the last time out before Robert Whittaker came up short in a very, very exciting fight. And afterwards, yeah, he was so honest. I saw him backstage and he just said, Michael, he said, I've never experienced that before. I didn't know what to do. He was just so good. There was no match illness. There was no, oh, that was the wrong decision. Nothing like that. It was just pure honesty. And then, after seeing the family for a few days, got straight on a plane and went out to Thailand to learn some more about the kicking side of things. I mean, a hard worker, that is an understatement.
You're right.
Well, you've seen already, he's thrown more kicks in the first minute of the fight than we've seen him before.
Right.
But that's...
Oh, he just hit a couple there.
Vettori feeling that Dolidze power early, it would appear.
Dolidze just is confident, man.
Well, you will be when you're knocking everyone out and beating them and tearing their legs off and kneeing their heads off.
Dolidze just took a big left hand from Marvin.
Yes, he did.
That's the thing, both of these guys can take a lot of punishment.
Well, neither Israel Adesanya nor Robert Whittaker were able to put Marvin Vettori away in 3 fights total.
Well, I think that's what you see, right, J.A., when you get to the top of the division. Dolidze will hit these guys like he hit some of the other lower-rank fighters, and they go down. These guys won't go down. The better fighters, it takes a lot more to get them out of there unless you land something perfect.
That's something Rafael Fiziev acknowledged this week about his last opponent, Rafael Dos Anjos. UFC 286 brought to you by Crypto.com. Join over 80 million users on the world's leading crypto app. Download the Crypto.com app now.
The problem for both guys as well, it's orthodox versus southpaw. So it makes you a little tentative, and of course there's the whole footwork battle. A nice one too by Marvin Vettori there. You see Dolidze's predominantly looking for hooks. Every time Marvin closes the distance, it's a left and right. It's a succession of fast hooks. They're very dangerous.
Marvin's doing a really good job of just touching him with those kicks. Inside, outside. And as long as he's straight with his shots and Dolidze's winging those hooks, he'll always get to the target a little sooner.
Oh. Vettori starting to find the range midway through round one. Vettori, former world title challenger, mixing up his attack beautifully early. right there from Vettori.
Yeah, nice little job. And again, the right hook for Vettori, right on the end of the combination.
Even this is more aggressive from Vettori also, but that's because the Lidze will not allow you to fight that slow fight. You feel like you have to take the fight to him, or you just feel like you're getting overwhelmed.
Well, listen, Marvin, you know, he's been around the UFC for a long time. He's only 29 years old, you know, and he's kind of pissed off, you know.
Yeah.
He truly believes
he trains
like he's going to be a future world champion, but he hasn't won the belt yet. That pisses him off.
On UFC Embedded, he was eating pasta after the weigh-in. He said, this is like the only time I'm happy.
Here's a little clash of heads.
Oh.
And guys, this happens when you have a southpaw and a conventional fighter. When they come together, you get a lot of clash of heads because of the split stance.
You do, but that was a bad one. That was significant.
No problem. Let's look. You both came together. It's okay. Just be careful, right? Ready?
Seemed like the Lidze got the better of that clash. Under 90 to go in the round.
Oh, for sure. Top of head versus the jaw. There's a nice kick.
The Lidze is the type of guy that he'll land something, right? That didn't land. He kicked his arms. But he takes his arms out at you. He starts to try to fight your ego. Hey, there's nothing bigger than a fighter's ego. You say, come on, man, fight me. Be a man. Most times that fighter will just try and stand and fight with you and put himself in danger and give you an opportunity. That's what the Lidze is trying to do to Marvin right now.
Well, that's the thing, you need the ego. That's why you believe you can stand in here and take on the best fighters in the world, but it can be a gift and a curse. Confidence is fantastic. Arrogance will cost you the fight, and so will right hands. Oh! From the Lidze, and again!
Three successive right hands for the Georgian.
The Lidze is just a brute.
Yeah, he is. It's not like the Lidze is doing everything technically right.
That's what I'm saying.
He just believes that his power will beat yours.
Because he has got a lot of power. He's committing to every shot. He's planting his feet. He's swinging. But Marvin can take a lot of punishment.
Yeah, he can.
As I said before, that fight with Paulo Costa. And let's remember, Costa came in 20 pounds heavier. Marvin Vettori didn't blink an eyelid. Said, yeah, sure, come on, let's go.
The Lidze literally slaps his arm going backwards. Instead of bringing his hand back to his chin, he's like backhand slapping, trying to just land.
Fascinating round one. This corner cam brought to you by Prime Hydration, the fastest growing beverage in history with only 25 calories, zero added sugar, BCAAs and electrolytes, now available at Walmart.
Only because you're moving left. If you stop moving to your right, you don't push to the fight.
It's your left. You're moving to your left, so he's throwing his right. You need to move to your right. Stay away from the
right. All right, let's take a look at that. Big left hook from Dalidze. Fires the right straight after it. Wasn't flush this time. Nice little jab. A 1-2 from Vettori. Dalidze comes on, fires a big inside low kick. An action-packed round from both men, both landing shots. Here's the end of the round. Dalidze fires, kind of just says, come on, let's go. Empties the tank, swings recklessly, but finds the mark on several occasions. Marvin Vettori, though, eats them all, fires right back. Tremendous opening round.
We have seen Marvin Vettori exude frustration at times in the octagon. He's never been bullied in there. We'll see how it goes in round two. Dalidze's in black, Vettori in white.
Yeah, you ain't gonna bully a man like Marvin Vettori. He lives and breathes the fight game. He's as tough as they come. He's motivated, he's disciplined. He'll travel the world looking for the best training.
Married to the game.
Married to the game indeed.
Vettori told us he's 5-1 in London. Last fight here all the way back in September of 2014. And he looked forward to the chance to stop Dalidze's hype train, as he called it. Dalidze was a plus 210 underdog when this fight began.
Nice evasive movement by Vettori there. Making Dalidze miss. It's often the case when you swing a lot of hooks like that, and Delizzi's not really setting them up. He's not throwing a shot, he's not faking, he's, you know, just throwing hooks in like succession.
But even now, Mike, like Marvin's fighting a great round, but then Delizzi explodes. He throws 10, 15 strikes just like this. He just starts to chase him down, and if Marvin doesn't answer, then the visuals may start to get you.
Pretty good stick and move there by Vettori.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this. Delizzi calling him on.
And there's fighting the ego a little bit, DC. Yep. 3.5 to go round two.
And Marvin's like, yeah, let's go. He ain't going to run away from
right,
it.
Right.
Vettori's not the type of guy that's going to take a back step.
UFC 286 brought to you by Tekken 8, the brand new game in the legendary franchise.
But that's so important with a guy like Delizzi. Because he said, come on, let's go. Vettori said, okay, he didn't throw anything. Right? He didn't throw anything. He's still taking his time.
Yeah, but that's not falling into the trap.
Yep.
You know, it's not.
So I'm saying, no, Delizzi didn't throw anything.
Yeah, yeah, no.
Marvin
right.
didn't back
yeah.
away, right? Marvin goes, no, let's go.
You know, a lot of those hooks, the lead right hook that Delizzi is throwing, they're getting blocked.
Yep.
Exactly. They're hitting the hand of Marvin Vettori. He's blocking them very well. Depending on the angle of the judge, though, they may think that they're connecting. Stiff jab.
Right hand to the chest by Delizzi. Vettori has landed 20 of 22 leg kicks thus far.
The problem with the leg kicks is they're landing, but he's kind of slapping them. That's why Delizzi doesn't feel like he needs to address him. If he starts turning over on those kicks a little bit more, putting a little more intent on him, Delizzi will have to take note of it.
I'd like to see Marvin double that jab up. He's got a nice jab, he's finding the hook. Double it up, throw a left high kick after it, or double jab straight left.
Harder kicks.
Some push kicks as well from Marvin, some teeth
body kick
section. Stop the advancing movement of Roman Delizzi.
He will not come
a little bit.
He won't stop, Mike.
Yeah.
He's gonna constantly be forward. That's who he is.
Yeah, but he will do if you takedown attempt. He's in on the single. Let's see the defense of Vettori. Nicely done.
Beautiful level change there by Delizzi. But even doing that, even though he didn't score the finish, even though he didn't score the takedown, that makes Marvin start to be aware of it. Delizzi's trying to throw the overhand right. Because he level changed to the legs, Vettori will then have to start addressing the takedown attempt. Open up the overhand.
Vettori moving his head a lot better here in round two, under a minute to go now.
Marvin's having a really good round this round.
Significant strike advantage, 53-39 for Vettori now.
Yeah, Delizzi slowed down a little bit here. Threw everything with full power in round one, which is great if you get the finish, but if you don't, you're going to slow down.
But that's just not knowing, right, Mike? Everybody he's hit up to this point, they fall.
That's the
but
thing.
He just have not been fighting in the top five. Once you get in the top five, guys don't just go down.
And Vettori has a wealth of five-round experience in the UFC. Not just the title fight, the 25-minute win over Paulo Costa. Nice right hand on the ear by Delizzi. Vettori's vision really on display here. Final seconds of the round. Oh, beautiful.
Put your pressure on him. You didn't do all that cardio for nothing. Put the pressure on him.
This fight's most likely 1-1. You gotta win this round. Every time you move to your left, he's throwing the big right hand, okay? Sometimes he's on the right kick. 70% of the time, I need you moving to your right, okay?
You see Marvin Vettori with the nice outside kick. Dude, that's been his best weapon to this point. Nice jab right there by Vettori. I thought Vettori fought a very good second round. Nice jab by Delizzi, but he just didn't do enough in that round. Little check Boom. Straight left hand by Marvin Vettori. He lands it. Great second round by Marvin.
Well, this month of March is absolutely loaded with live content. Over 30 live events exclusively on Fight Pass. Watch the next wave of combat sports stars coming from LFA, Ares FC, Cage Warriors, Fury FC, Eternal, and the premiere of ADCC on UFC Fight Pass. All right, third and final round here could very well come down to cardio.
As it often does, John, you get two men that are, you know, pretty much equally matched. Neither can really insert any dominance. It's very competitive. The fitter guy's going to take over. The fitter guy's going to win. The guy that's tired is going to start making mistakes.
Well, you heard Dewey Cooper tell Marvin, you did too much cardio, right? You've done too much cardio. We got to get this round.
You're going to push the pace. Force your opponent to up the tempo by attacking him.
I feel like for Delizé to win this round, he has got to get active like he was in round one. And Vittori's got to do this. I never thought that a more technical, prettier fight would benefit Marvin Vettori, but right now it does.
Well, no, it will, because Delizé, as I said, he's very effective, and he's very good, and he's got skills, but he's a big, brutish kind of guy. If Marvin can get up the fence and implement such a pace and weaponize his cardio, and by that I mean force Delizé to fight at a higher output, get him tired, get him blowing heavy, he's going to make mistakes, and then Marvin can find the chin with more frequency.
Vettori staying busy and landing effectively inside out on the leg, and then up top, under 3.5 to decide it.
This fight is on the table. It's going to be about who's more active, who wants it more.
Also on the table, in theory, Marvin Vittori's all-important number 4 ranking.
Absolutely. That's what Delizé wants. Of course, wants the victory. Nice check, right hook by Vettori, then uses the footwork, circular movement, trying to avoid the fence. Very wise.
Oh.
Good connection for Delizé.
Another one for Delizé. Two really clean shots. I mean, Delizé is just a bully in there, man. He just is in your face the whole time, looking for openings. Oh,
that's some nice work.
Delizé's landed most of his big shots near the fence, back to the center now.
It's a lot of low kicks.
Yeah.
Oh! Cracking right from Delizé. Vettori resets. Jab is there for Delizé.
Delizé has had a real good minute.
He has.
And he's kind of tightened everything up a little bit, right, Johnny? Threw the jab, threw the right hand.
I'd say it's still anyone's fight.
Oh, yeah, it is.
You know, 2 minutes left. Whoever really goes for it here.
You hear Vettori's corner saying, you have to turn it up.
That was a heavy low kick.
Oh!
Oh, both guys landing big shots in that sequence.
Delizé has a chin on him, man. He just believes that he can take your shot. You will not be able to take his clean.
Dropped down and partially landed a right hand. Vettori back to work with the kicking game. Vettori rolled with that offering nicely and now lands an inside leg kick again.
Yeah, he's butchering the low kick, the inside thigh of Roman Delizé, the lead leg.
Delizé doesn't kick. He doesn't kick at all.
You see the redness. Look at the bruise on the left leg. Nice series of punches there by Vettori as well. Found the mark on several occasions.
Oh, that leg is beat up. Oh, it's purple.
It's butchered, man. There it is again. And it buckled a little bit then.
I mean, that leg is just destroyed. Could you imagine if Roman Delizé actually went to the body? When he's got you so worried about his shots up top, if he just dug like a right uppercut?
That's good for Marvin, that he managed to separate him and get him off. 30 seconds. In a sensational fight.
Very evenly matched.
Nice defense there by Delizé. Whiffs on a right hand. Not a lot of grappling in this one. Down the stretch we come.
A nice exchange at the end for Vittori in a very close fight.
All right, so the one-time training partners, Marvin Vittori and Roman Dolidze, go the distance. Credit to Vittori for giving Dolidze the opportunity, and Roman certainly proving without a shadow of a doubt that he belongs with the elite middleweights in the UFC.
So that was a great fight. Here we are in round three, some of the action. A knee just misses Marvin Vittori there. Vittori lands a right hand there, just misses the right of Dolidze. Dolidze storms forward here, throws the left, swings the right, gets through, connects with Vittori as he backs up. A left hand for Vittori, gets through there. I mean, just back and forth. I mean, both men landed a lot of shots. Some brutal inside low kicks for Marvin Vittori, and a very close fight.
Well, Roman Dolidze got off to a furious start. Outstanding response in round two from Marvin Vittori. Well, another massive championship rematch. Headlines UFC 287 from Miami. 3 weeks from tonight, April 8th, the longtime middleweight king, Israel Adesanya, looking to regain his throne against his arch nemesis and the now defending champ, Alex Pereira. Also, Gilbert Arrillo Burns versus Jorge Gamebred Masvidal, and so much more. UFC 287 live from Miami, Florida, April 8th on ESPN Plus pay-per-view in the U.S. UFC.com/pay-per-view everywhere else. All right, with the official decision now, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. The judges score the contest 29-28, 29-28, and 30-27 for the winner by unanimous decision, Marvin the Italian Dream, Vittori!
I'm here with Marvin Vittori. Marvin, how good does it feel to get a victory?
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.